diced tomato. And my diced tomato, I'm going to go ahead and put the diced tomato in like that. And I have my seasoning, which is some Goya. I'm going to add some Goya. You probably want to do about a teaspoon or two of that, maybe. I have some fresh garlic here. Garlic and herb Lipton recipe that I'm gonna use. I love using this. It will zest up anything. And plus, you know, because Lipton is known for making soups and whatnot, you know, along with the juices and everything, like this just gives your meat flavor all the way through. So every single bite of the meatloaf is gonna be the bomb. Last thing I'm gonna add now is I got two eggs. So two raw eggs. There's one. And I got another one laying around here. My second. So now I'm gonna show you what this looks like. So if you can see that, all the seasonings, everything in there. Now I'm going to mush it together. As you can see, I have a glove on because I don't want all of this in my nails, and I want to be comfortable getting it all the way through. Anytime you do anything like this, I mean, you know, it's just sanitary for everybody to have gloves on when you're doing stuff like this. Especially, you know, you just don't want something for somebody to get under their nails. You know, I mean, my hands are clean, but still. Like a gravy. I didn't feel like doing it right now. But sometimes I'll make like a gravy. And I put gravy, you know, in my mixture. And that is key to having a bomb meatloaf. Even if you use ground beef, make some homemade gravy and put some gravy in your meatloaf as you're mixing together, because once it starts cooking, all of those juices and the gravy, just that lifting, everything just blends together, and it just makes a really juicy meatloaf. But I didn't feel like doing that today, making a homemade gravy, so I didn't do it. So this is done. I have mixed all of this stuff together really well. I already have my oven on 350. So it's already on. So that is really good. And a lot of people, they say, well, how do you make your, you know, meatloaf stick? My meatloaf doesn't stick unless I use breadcrumbs or No, this and that. When I use turkey meat, let me tell you, I don't need none of that stuff. And mine stays just fine. I don't have no problems. My daughter Imani, like, this is her one of her favorite dishes. She loves meatloaf. Like, she loves turkey meatloaf. So, with that being said, and I could have used a bigger pan because I used so much meatloaf. So this is going to be really thick slices. And that's okay. These will be really thick slices. Once it's done. And when I do my topping, you know, most people, they use ketchup. Now, I'll take ketchup and brown sugar and stuff like that and kind of mix it together with maybe a little bit of barbecue sauce or something. And that's what I put on the top of mine, just to give it a little flavor instead of just the regular, you know, meatloaf flavor that everybody's used to. So at this point, my meatloaf is now done. And it's finished. And it looks pretty. So I'm going to show you what my meatloaf looks like. You can see that. So now, I'm gonna grab some foil.